ChatGPT-5 just launched and I'm about to push it to its limits. Can this AI actually make a full Mario Bros. Style game in Unreal Engine 5.6 just from text prompts? I'm talking about enemies you can stomp, coins to collect, blocks to smash, and a finish line to win, all built with no assets, no plugins, just default Unreal Engine props. Here's the challenge. If this game is fully playable, with every feature working exactly like I'd imagine, by the end of this video, I'll call it a win for AI game development. If even one core feature breaks or can't even finish in time, it's game over. I'm following every step ChatGPT gives me, even when it makes zero sense. And you'll see every problem I hit, every fix I make, and whether AI can actually pull this off. So I hit ChatGPT-5 with this prompt. Make me a simple game in Unreal Engine 5.6 like Mario Bros. For the NES using blueprints. I want enemies that can stomp, coins to collect with a score in the upper right, smashable blocks, and a finish line to win. The AI gave me a 9-step plan. It sounded solid, but here's the catch. ChatGPT-5 doesn't really know my exact setup, my exact workflow, or the little roadblocks that pop up in Unreal. That's where I come in, the human in the loop, making judgment calls when AI's instructions aren't good enough. Step 1 should have been the easiest, create a new project using the side scroller template. Problem is that in Unreal Engine 5.6, it's gone. ChatGPT's plan was already out of date, so I had to improvise. I picked the third person template and I named it Side Scroller and started adopting it into a 2D game. In the BP third person character, I set constraint to plane to true, locked the Y axis, boosted jump velocity to 700, and I set the air control to 0.65. That's the thing with AI instructions. It hands you a recipe, but sometimes the first ingredient doesn't even exist anymore. ChatGPT's camera setup sounded good. Add a spring arm, switch to orthographic, adjust the ortho width. Problem was that my character already had a spring arm and rotating it was locked. The AI didn't account for that. So I ditched the orthographic, stayed in the perspective, and manually moved the camera to negative 90 degrees for a side view. It was better, but it was still glitchy. I went back to ChatGPT-5 and this time I asked it to be more specific. And this time it nailed it. The fix was to uncheck use pawn control rotation. That got me close, but the final breakthrough came from me, turning off inherent jaw on the spring arm for that locked 2D Mario style view. The AI set the table, but it still took a human to tweak to serve the meal. With the camera ready, ChatGPT assumed I'd just start building the level. The problem was that I planned to make it from scratch, but time was slipping away, so I decided to modify the existing level instead. And instantly hit another snag. The whole thing wasn't even facing the camera. ChatGPT didn't warn me about this. If I followed this plan blindly, the game would have played sideways. So I rotated the entire platform layout to match the camera. Then I added platforms of different heights and lengths. The AI gave me the general idea, but without me steering, this would have been dead on arrival. Now for the coins, ChatGPT's 5 plan was solid, except it forgot a key detail. How to actually make the score appear on screen. It built the car but forgot the dashboard. So I prompted specifically for the HUD element, made a BP coin with a sphere mesh, gave it a gradient so it looked good spinning, and I also added a rotating movement at 180 degrees per second, which is set by default. Then I created a HUD widget, bound the text to a score variable, and made sure overlapping a coin updated the display. Without the extra prompt from me, the coins would have worked mechanically, but players would have never seen their score. And as I was getting into the groove, my brain reminded me that Battlefield 6 beta was live. The urge to procrastinate was real, but I had a Goomba to stomp. Feel free to try it next weekend, it'll be free and open as well. ChatGPT's 5 block system sounded straightforward. Collision under the block, check if the player's jumping, spawn a coin. The problem was that it never told me exactly how to check the player's upward velocity. It was too vague, so I had to go back and prompt for specifics. So I cast to the player, got the velocity, and I broke the vector. Then I checked with a branch node if C was greater than 0. The AI had the right concept, but without my intervention, the block would have been just decoration. Enemies were where ChatGPT's plan really showed its limits. It said, move the enemy forward on tick. Easy, right? Problem was that my enemies were ignoring walls entirely. The AI didn't include obstacle detection. I set up a move speed and direction variable multiplied by delta seconds, used add actor world offset with sweep, still didn't work as expected. After 30 minutes of tweaking, I gave up on the full patrol of AI for now. Set direction to -1 so that they'd walk toward me, and focused on making the stomp and hurt collisions work. Without my call to simplify, I would still be debugging instead of moving forward. Finally, the finish line. ChatGPT said make a win trigger. The problem was that that was a big vague for a climatic moment. So I took it a bit further. I modeled a flagpole with a cylinder and a cone, slapped on a Mario red material, added box collision, and put it high up for maximum glory. The AI gave me the concept, but I gave it the personality. So can you make a game with ChatGPT-5? Yes, but only if you're ready to guide it. The verdict? ChatGPT isn't your replacement. It's your new, tireless, and occasionally very confused intern. Use it right and you'll build things faster than ever before. So here's my next question for you. What classic game should I push this AI to build next? A top-down Zelda-style adventure? A frantic retro space shooter? Pitch me your best AI challenge in the comments and maybe you'll see it in the next video. And if you like this AI dev experiment, click on the video to the left and watch my breakdown on whether AI will replace 3D modelers.